Welcome back to another awesome movie recap. Today, we have an action-packed Japanese sci-fi thriller for you, Inuyashiki. Like always, there will be spoilers. The film starts with the Inuyashiki family moving into a new home. The father, Ichiro Inuyashiki, is a middle-aged man. Although he looks like an old man, he is pleased with his purchase and hopes that the rest of his family are too. But they aren't. His son Takashi and his daughter Mari, who is a bit of a witch with a B, complain that it's too small and cramped. They go on to ignore their father and leave to go to a restaurant with their mother. The next evening, after a terrible day at work, Ichiro sits on his patio alone. Suddenly, a dog approaches him through the gate. The old man finds a note tied to the dog's collar, which says her name is Hanako, and that she's been abandoned. The man's wife then appears at the door and gives him a letter after telling him to get rid of the dog. The man reads the letter, which explains that he needs further testing at the hospital. The next day at the hospital, Ichiro is told that he has stage 4 cancer and discovers that he only has 3 months left to live at best. He goes home and calls his family, who are either at work or school, but no one picks up. Later that evening, he tries to tell his family about his diagnosis, but no one is interested in listening to him. After his failed attempt at saying anything, Ichiro takes Hanako for a walk and ends up in a park. Whilst there, he notices a younger man sitting in the dark. Suddenly, the sky lights up in a brilliant white before something crashes into both the old man and the boy, killing them instantly. Fear not though, it's not the end of the film, because the next thing we know, the old man is waking up in the middle of the park, and it's daytime. He goes back home where his family doesn't really care that he's been missing. At breakfast, the old man discovers that he can't taste anything. Getting worried, he excuses himself to his room. Once in his bedroom, his hands start smoking. The man's arm then opens up to reveal a highly advanced, robot-like structure. Before the rest of his body does the same, it turns out that what crashed into him that night in the park was an alien spaceship. Whilst the old man is figuring out his new body, his daughter is in class with, surprise surprise, the same boy who also got crushed by aliens. The boy called Hiroshi Shigami, or as I'm going to call him, Psycho Boy, goes to his friend's house and shows him what his new body can do, eventually showing him exactly what it looks like now. Meanwhile, the old man has been fired from his job. On the way home, he finds an injured pigeon. He picks it up, and then some crazy x-ray thing happens which allows him to see exactly what is wrong with the bird and heal it. After saving the pigeon, the old man realizes he has super hearing. He hears a woman begging a doctor to save her son. Deciding that he must help, Ichiro heads to the hospital, sneaks into the boy's room, and heals his injury. The boy wakes up and the old man leaves, happy to have saved a life. Whilst this is happening, Hiro and his friend Ando go to school, where the psycho boy takes on Ando's bullies, forcing them to apologize. Afterwards, he is approached by a girl called Shion, who tells him that she fancies him. He thanks her and walks away. That evening, Hiro goes to his father's house and almost shoots him, using his new abilities. However, at the last moment, he changes his mind. On his way back from his father's house, Psycho Boy gets the overwhelming urge to kill. He wanders into a stranger's home, where a family of three are sitting and talking in their living room. They notice the boy, who is standing at the door to the room, and demand for him to get out. This doesn't work too well for them though, as the psycho forms a gun with his fingers and shoots them. The old man is at the hospital, secretly curing the sick patient, when his super hearing hears a cry for help. He takes off running, trying to find the cry, which is coming from the house that Psycho Boy is in. But the old man is too late. By the time he gets to the house, he finds all the people have been killed. He tries to heal the young girl, but it doesn't work. He then hears a noise from the living room and goes to investigate. He finds Psycho Boy standing and staring at the dead bodies of the parents. The old man recognizes the boy as the one who was at the park with him the night he became a cyborg. Not giving the man a chance to talk, the boy shoots him and leaves the house. Not being human, the old man doesn't die obviously, and runs after the boy who has flown away. The next day, the news reports the murders from the previous night, which leads to Ando asking the boy if he was the killer. The boy doesn't deny his accusation, and instead goes on to refer to himself as a god. Horrified at what his friend has become, Ando unfriends him and then runs away. Psycho Boy goes back home where his mother tells him that he'll have to live with his father, as she has inoperable pancreatic cancer. Hiro promises her that he won't let her die and hugs her tightly. At the Inuyashiki household, Takashi, the son, is being told off for stealing money, and the witch is told off for skipping school. Unfazed, Mari tells her parents that she isn't planning on going to college, as she wants to become a manga artist instead. That night, Ichiro berates himself for not being able to provide for his family, claiming he's not a hero if he can't even protect them. As he does this though, his super hearing picks up a prayer from Ando, who asks God to stop Psycho Boy. Realizing that no one else would be able to do this, and because he wanted to be a hero, the old man goes outside and summons his jetpack booster rocket thing, and flies into the night sky with his dog in his arms. He follows the voice until he finds Ando sitting on the bench in the park, where everything had started. He explains to the boy what happened that caused him and Psycho Boy to change. Ando then asks the old man to stop Psycho Boy before things get worse. The only problem is, Ichiro doesn't exactly know what the cyborg body weaknesses are. As morning arrives, the two and the dog, of course, go to a junkyard, where the old man practices shooting like Hiro, although he's definitely not a natural at it. Meanwhile, Hiro and his mother have gone to the hospital for a checkup on her cancer. The mother asks how long she has left to live, but the doctor tells her that the cancer cells have completely disappeared. Surprised but ecstatic, the two head home. On their way back home, they are intercepted by police, who want to question Psycho Boy about the murders from the other night. The boy quickly takes off running, taking out quite a few policemen as he escapes. Even though he has evaded capture for now, it's not long before his face is plastered all over the city, as the news puts out a special alert to be on the lookout for him. On her way back from school, Shion, the girl who fancies Psycho Boy, comes across him. She invites the serial killer back to her home, as any normal person would obviously, where she reveals that she lives with her grandmother, as both of her parents died from illness. Knowing it's hereditary, she tells the boy that she probably won't have long left to live either. Oblivious to what has happened, the old man continues to practice his shooting ability. He's gotten better at it, but it clearly still needs work. Claiming that using his abilities makes him thirsty, Ando theorizes that water is the power source for the cyborgs. Not long after drinking a sports drink though, the old man throws it back up again right into poor Ando's face. Looking at the ingredients, Ando realizes that the water might be a strength for the cyborgs, but sodium, like salt, is a weakness. As the two walk back home together, they are spotted by the witch. Not realizing that they've been seen, they split up. The witch, I mean, Mari, confronts Ando. However, he manages to confuse her and run away. Psycho Boy is sitting in the spare bedroom of Shion's house. He watches the news, using his super cyborg abilities, and discovers that his mother has committed suicide because of what he did. Reading the comments on the news video, Psycho Boy gets angry. He finds the troll, who claims that he sent the mother's address and personal information to the media, and threatens to kill him. Thinking it's just a joke, the troll dares him to do it. Not long after, Psycho Boy's face appears on the troll's screen. He asks why the man sent the information to the media, to which the troll just laughs at him. This is a very big mistake though, as because he's a cyborg, Hiro can interact with all kinds of technology, which is exactly how he shoots the troll through the computer. After killing the troll, Psycho Boy posts in the chat that he'll kill everyone on there. True to word, Psycho Boy goes on a killing spree, killing, well, quite a lot of people through their screens. After doing that, he goes into the kitchen for a drink, where Shion finds him. Psycho Boy tells the girl that he is the killer that everyone's after, but she doesn't believe him. He then shows her his robotic body, proving that he is the killer. He then kidnaps Shion, flying away with her into the night sky. Not that she would listen, as whilst flying through the night sky, the girl asks Hiro to stay with her, which he promises to do. The next morning, both cyborgs are watching the news, which recounts how 26 people were shot dead the previous night whilst in Tokyo. Whilst talking to Ando through his super special cyborg abilities, the witch catches the old man and demands to know what is going on. Ichiro ignores her though and leaves the house. Good for him. Later that night, Shion watches as Hiro sleeps. She then goes to grab a drink of water, but when she turns around, she sees an entire squad of special forces, with their guns pointing at her. Sensing that something is wrong, Hiro walks into the kitchen, and quickly grabs Shion as the police open fire. Psycho Boy then forms his own gun and shoots all the officers dead, but it's too late. Hiro looks to Shion and sees that she is dead. Devastated, Psycho Boy flies out of the apartment and into the night. The next day, as the police address the murders on the TV, the old man begs his family not to go out for the day and leave all of the technology off. They ignore him like usual and leave. Meanwhile, Psycho Boy vows to kill everyone in Japan. He sets up a camera and takes over all the screens in Shinjuku City, which doesn't bode well for them. He then starts firing into the crowds that have gathered, killing as many people as he can. The old man back at the junkyard with Ando hears the people screaming for help and goes off to stop Hiro. Meanwhile, Psycho Boy continues to shoot people through his super special cyborg abilities. He is interrupted by Ichiro and Ando, who take over the screens and tell people to turn off all their devices, as that's how they can get shot. Even though his broadcast has been interrupted, Psycho Boy has another plan up his sleeve. He unleashes dozens of small missiles and controls them to crash all throughout the city. The old man sees where Psycho Boy is hiding and flies up to meet him, telling him to stop killing people. Obviously, this doesn't work, and the fight begins. Ichiro shoots Hiro first, but it does absolutely nothing. Then they both take off into the air, with the boy chasing the old man. The two men continue to fly around the city, with Psycho Boy letting off missiles in an attempt to blow up the old man. Although he might not need to do this, as the man's flying isn't all that great, as he's trying to dodge Hiro. Ichiro hears his daughter's voice asking for help. He locates the building that she's in, but as he's distracted, Psycho Boy is able to shoot one of his jet engine things. The two end up facing off on the side of a tall building. Hiro punches the old man through the side of a building and into a helicopter that is hovering on the other side. Their arrival doesn't end well for the individuals inside the helicopter. With two of them being killed straight away, Ichiro manages to save the third man, only for him to be shot by Psycho Boy when they get to safety. Whilst talking, Psycho Boy takes out his water and starts to drink it. However, Ichiro shoots the bottle, causing the water to spill everywhere. He then takes out his own bottle of water, which is actually the sports water full of sodium. Not knowing the difference, Hiro tackles the old man, takes the water off him, and starts to drink it. He then starts firing more missiles at Ichiro, who tries to avoid them by flying up into space. But it doesn't work, and the blasts end up catching him. Not far behind the missiles is Psycho Boy, who catches up to the old man and grabs him by the throat. Just as it looks like it might be the end for the old man, the sodium kicks in, and Hiro starts to malfunction. Now released from the hold, Ichiro readies his own missiles. The old man fires, destroying Hiro once and for all. After finishing the fight, the man flies back to the building where Mari was. He finds her laying face down on the ground, seemingly dead. But after a few minutes of trying to bring her back, she regains consciousness again. While the old man and his daughter have a touching moment, Hiro interrupts by kicking Ichiro in the face. The boy then starts shooting all of the survivors in the room, leaving Mari for last. Just before he is able to kill her, the old man tackles him to the ground, making him shoot her in the chest, but away from the heart, so maybe she'll be okay. Just before Psycho Boy is able to finish her off, Ichiro stops him again, causing the boy to beat up the old man, so much so that his head comes apart, and Mari is able to see the robot that her dad has become. Stuck on the floor, the old man tries to touch his daughter's hand so that he can heal her, but Hiro doesn't let him. Instead, he picks Mari up and throws her out the window. Seeing this happen, Ichiro becomes super powerful and rushes the boy. Psycho Boy runs toward the man as well, but as he punches his face, the boy's arm smashes into bits. This doesn't happen for Ichiro though. He is able to land a solid blow to the boy's torso and smash that to bits as well. Fueled by the power of love, as cliche as it sounds, the old man is able to catch up to his falling daughter and save her before she hits the ground. After a quick heal with his super special cyborg abilities, Mari is A-okay again. Then for no particular reason, the old man flies off. The film ends with the police reporting that Hiro's body has been found by the police, and that it was a mysterious miracle worker who helped stop the psychotic serial killer. While listening to the news, the Inuyashiki family are having their breakfast. The mother and son leave, however, Mari stays with her dad, who does nothing but smile happily as he listens to the news. Well, that's our super special recap for you guys. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time!